Thank you very much. One of the phrases that's been bandied about quite a lot in fitness lately, more than ever before, is mobility. And Coach Pat Hennigan of Jack's Fitness Academy is back with us to talk about that word. It is kind of a more recent phenomenon, obviously not for professional athletes, but for those of us who just kind of dabble, we're learning that it's important. Why?
Mobility is a funny concept because, as you said, everything in fitness is cyclical. Everything is, you don't want to use the word trendy, but things come and go and people forget knowledge and then it gets resurrected and gets broadcasted again. Mobility is one of those things that is everywhere right now. It's a buzzword, and a lot of people, unfortunately, use it as an excuse to actually not work out. So I hear a lot of times people say something like, I don't have the right mobility to perform a squat. Well, you know what will build that mobility is actually practicing your squat and getting stronger in the squat. So it's a double-edged sword because you can absolutely have limited mobility, which can cause pain and cause you from functioning less than optimally in your daily life. But you can also have too much mobility, which we often see with certain populations, that can cause just the same amount of problems in a different landscape, we'll say.
What is the difference between flexibility and mobility?
So flexibility, it refers to the length of the muscle, and then mobility refers to the way the joint actually moves. So the two obviously have a relationship, but what we have to keep in mind is that muscles have a distinct range of motion, and then the joints that they attach to also have a distinct range of motion. So we need to keep both those things into account when programming, creating, or prescribing mobility for people with certain problems.
Okay, so what would be an example of the difference between an exercise you might do for flexibility versus an exercise you might do for mobility in that same general area?
Well, so I don't think we should necessarily separate the two. I think that the two should kind of be blended together. So
okay.
If you perform a flexibility exercise correctly, it will increase mobility, and vice versa. If you perform a mobility exercise correctly, it should increase flexibility. So if we take, for example, what's everyone complaining about? Their upper back and their hip flexors. We don't necessarily want to have a mobile lower back. That's where the tight hip flexors come in. Your lower back feels immobile because the hip flexors are tight and putting it in a bad position. So if we take the hip flexor stretch, if you set it up properly, so if I set up in a perfect line, I guess I'll awkwardly go down like this, knee up to the shoulder like that, what we're actually doing is we're increasing the flexibility of the hip flexors, because what people forget is that the hip flexors are not just in the hips. They're actually in the abdomen themselves too. So we have to take the hips, the ribs, and the spine into consideration when stretching these muscles, and then that will actually build that mobility in the hip as well as build the flexibility in the hip flexor. So when we tie the two together, that's when we get a really effective dose of exercise, mobility, and flexibility at once.
Okay, so if you're starting a routine, a workout routine, and within the course of a few minutes, we never can get an all-encompassing conversation going, but you should be asking your trainer or your physician or whoever it is you're working with about mobility, because that is important. Is it mostly before or after a workout?
Absolutely. So mobility it's all the time, because you want the mobility to function happily in regular life. You want to be able to do your daily tasks in a way that doesn't cause you pain, and in a way that you can do it and feel like you're fluid while doing it, not, you know, taking your time going down, grabbing a table. You want to have that requisite mobility to live a good life. And then also within the workout, the more you have that kind of perfect mobility, not too much, not too little, the better effect you'll get from actually training itself. So mobility is definitely an individualized thing, because everyone's is going to be different in different areas just based on the fact that we're different people, different heights, different limb lengths, different beginning points, everything like that. So mobility is definitely an individualized point, and that's where a trainer or like a really good fitness class can come in, because you can get those individual points of those tiny tweaks you need to make to get the right amount of mobility for yourself.
Okay, so one of the things that I've learned through you, if I'm being honest, it was through you, I would say something like, oh, I can't work out on this day because I have something very grueling coming up the next day, and you say, well, then you're going to work on your mobility, because that's important. So for more information with Coach Pat, you can go to jacksfitnessacademy.com. We definitely have it up on your screen, and we appreciate that. And now we've learned. Look at that. Yeah. Taught us. We'll be right back.